We missed our flight, and we're gonna sleep in the airport tonight. I've never done it before, but it should be fun.
What's up, guys? My name's Brandon. It's been a long time since I've been on YouTube. Right now, we are in New York City. We just missed our flight. So we are gonna be staying overnight until the next day so we can go back home to LA. We just finished a startup accelerator program, but the startup has fantastic momentum. And so my flight's at 7 a.m. We have a bunch of time. I think I'm just gonna grind. Might as well like pull an all-nighter, grind, work. And then when I go home, I'll just sleep it off. Cause why not? Today's midnight grind goal. I'm gonna start up YouTube. This is my first YouTube video. Start up YouTube again, post some short form content. Maybe I could do one or two pieces. That'd be really, really nice. Cause I have so much content that I went to. I went to Chicago for the restaurant food convention and I pitched my startup at a food tech competition in Brooklyn. There's so much content to be made and a lot of time right now. I think this is the perfect time. And because we missed our flight, we can't check in our bags. So we have all our bags right here. Sorry if I'm a little rusty on the camera. I have not vlogged on YouTube in like literally three and a half years. Like, it's been a long time. So bear with me. I'm gonna stutter, I appreciate it. Okay, bye-bye. We're gonna move to a different spot to work just because it's kind of boring there. We're gonna find another spot, this corner. Gonna be right here and I can watch the sunset. This is where I'm sitting. I wish I documented the startup before the accelerator ended. Like, I literally started documenting it the day after it ended. So we're gonna do that starting today. I can't get any work done. Look at all these snacks. The airport stuff is like ridiculously and notoriously expensive. Like, water bottle,
$8.
Bro. Like, I'm not gonna have anything until 4 a.m. tomorrow, so maybe something like a chicken Caesar salad. This actually looks pretty good. I'm gonna guess it's like $25. And there's no price. No price means expensive.
It is now 8:42. The next goal for the next 20-30 minutes is just reorganize my computer
and making pillars of like what I want to do. So one is like YouTube, one is like Instagram Reels, one is like Plate Post, which is a startup. It's a lot of stuff to figure out. And then one is my email. Right now I'm doing my bookmarks tab. This finished a $17 out. It was actually pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. I was pleasantly surprised, but $17 is like good. In-N-Out the burger. It's a double dub, two double doubles, drinks, animal fries, a shake, three double doubles even for $17. You can get so much food. Then I don't know why airports and like places like that, they charge like an exorbitant amount of fees. Like, I know they can, but there must be some like economical reason. You know? It's over. It's done. They're kicking us out. So, gotta find a new spot. Looking, I'm pretty tired. So, maybe it's a new spot to sleep. I need a dollar, dollar, dollar. That's what I need. Hey, hey. Well, I need a dollar, dollar, dollar. That's what I need. Hey, hey. Said, I need a dollar, dollar, dollar. That's what I need. And if I share with So as I've been walking around the airport, I've noticed there's so many digital screens, especially in the new airports, and people are so visual. So I'm glad they're transitioning and moving to that space. But I wonder if it's like maybe the play of doing video menus for restaurants is we've done QR codes, we've done the TV screens, but maybe there's some sort of integration where we can do with like things like this. You know, there's a kiosk, there's like TV screens over there. And then that would be pretty cool, especially in an airport. You're just walking around, moving quick. You're not like there forever to like find what you want. You just look really quickly to see because you're always on the go. As I'm like talking about these like digital screens, there's even more of them. Every time people are walking, these are like digital displays as advertisement, but they could be also used for food. Like, hey, come to terminal A2 for this breakfast burger or something, you know? So I don't know. So many more digital screens that I've seen that could be integrated with what we do at Plate Post. It's just a matter of time before it happens. So it's almost a speed to execution game where we have to just execute very quickly. How can we get great videos of great food into restaurants and whatnot? And then from there, we go from there. Yeah, I guess we go from there. What's cool about seeing like where your product can potentially go in the world is that if you see people using something similar, you can ask and just basically interview them on the spot. So last time I was at this exact airport, there were QR codes deployed. And so what I did was I went to the diners, didn't tell them about plate posts, nothing like that. Just went to the diners, asked if they've ever used this QR code, their ordering experience. It's really interesting because you can get really authentic feedback about how the current products in the world already are being used and how people like or dislike them. And then we can find gaps in the market of like, hey, maybe they dislike this. And if 100 people in a row get the same dislikes, maybe there's a thing there, right? So it's good to always like, I found that it's always good to like have some user interviews, especially when you see people using like, in some ways, competing products.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
I've always thought, I've only sat business class a couple times. What if, like, instead of like the menus that you get, like PDF-wise, what if you got like a digital experience for business class and first class flyers? Maybe that'd be nicer or more elevated? I don't know. Row 22C. Before I started the startup, I was like always grinding on planes. I go to always like get work done, pull out my laptop. Whether it was nighttime, morning time, I would just pull out my laptop and get work done. But I found that like recharging on an airport instead, or on an airplane, is a lot easier. We just got out of our first flight from Newark to Utah. And we have about 30 minutes for our next flight, and we're just gonna do a couple things. But we wanna just look at all the digital TVs and screens they have for all the restaurants to see how other restaurants are already doing stuff, right? So that's what we'll be doing. It's so interesting, I forget, when you're like vlogging in public, everyone stares. It's like, it's been so long, but it's been fun. So we're approaching our first drink restaurant type thing, Jamba Juice. Let's see if they have a digital menu. They do. Ah, okay, this is what I've been noticing. A lot of menus have been switching to like photos. So let's look. So like all the menus now have some sort of photos. I remember this was not a thing before. It was all text. So consumer behavior is shifting. It is shifting to some sort of visual aspect. A lot of the new airports have switched to these like digital ordering things just to make like life easier for consumers, but it's still not at every US airport, of course, and then globally, it's not even there for sure. So we're on our second, I'm just kind of curious. This place is called Garbanzo Mediterranean Fresh. I see the TVs. Let's just take a look. Oh, so they have some sort of photo, and then one TV is like off completely. I think the photos work. Interesting. It's always great to like continue to learn more about the space of what you're trying to build. But for me, I'm building the video menus for restaurants, and that could be deployed by QR code TVs. And so going to places like airports, festivals, dining halls, to see what they already implement is a great way to see what consumers already use. So like, for example, this place, Beans and Brews. It's like a physical menu. I think we need to do one more for like good measure, at least. Because I'm just walking down the street from my last flight to my next flight. And then we're just gonna go to see all the restaurants on this line of, this terminal, basically. Wow, look how many people there are. It's kind of crazy to like, just talk to an inanimate object, which is this camera, in front of all these people. It's a little weird. I'm still getting used to it. You either don't care about it or you care about it and it really affects you. I remember early on when I was filming myself, it was so like nerve-wracking and awkward. It still kind of is, but I kind of got over it. You have to like basically remember that no one cares. They'll see you and they'll look, and 10 seconds later they'll forget about you. That's the key. There's some restaurants like that, text, menus, but then if you walk over just a few steps, you have kiosks. This one has a digital TV. Like, every single place is somewhat different and there's no standardization. And even this place like is just like a printed menu board that costs like $800. Boom. There's no standardization. Like there's one right here, there's a line, and there's one right there. And I bet this place maybe has QR codes. I don't know. Let's see. No QR codes. Oh, there's like a little menu board right here. You sit down, you grab the table. It's the same. Last flight. and then we're home. We're finally back home, like home. I gotta see my family. It's been like 3 months. It's been a long time. Oh man, it's quite emotional, you know?